again?
I was thinking strawberry.
In the shape of a butterfly?
Nice touch. I'll give them a call and find out what time our high tide is. Is that the sun coming up for a second time? No, it's my darling daughter.
What's going on?
What, a father can't admire his daughter?
You're not planning anything for tomorrow, are you?
Planning? Me? Of course not.
You better not be.
Planning? What would we be planning?
Here you go, man. What's this?
It's the thing you wanted, the sonar thingy.
I said you could get side scan sonar. This is a fish detector.
Yeah, what's the difference?
It's the difference between night and day, Nate. The difference between success and failure.
Hey, watch it. I borrowed this from my dad. If anything happens to it, it's
not what I want.
Well, you should have been more specific.
I was. You know, I don't think you cut out for this, Nate.
Oh, yeah?
Says who? You?
What are you doing, anyway?
I'm on a hunt. And if I find what I'm looking for, I'll rewrite the history books.
I think you might be losing it, man.
Hi, Lewis.
Emma, hi. Wilfred, just the man I want to see.
This is the place to find me.
Yes, a two-part proposition.
Try one to start.
Right. Wilfred, how much time have you actually spent on the waves since opening the business?
Try none. Then what can you do? Business is business.
Mm. Well, that's all about to change, because you're about to hire me and spend the rest of the day at the beach.
Lewis, that's not a bad idea.
Yes. Get to it.
Wait a minute. You call that a job interview?
Yeah. Yeah, work for me. Wilfred.
Got all the information I need.
No, you've got to do it properly. You've got to ask him questions.
Like...
Lewis, why do you want to work at the Juice Net Cafe?
I'm committed to providing fresh juice and friendly service to the masses, and I need money quickly. Wilfred, I am prepared to work for as little as $30.
A day?
An hour.
That's unrealistic, Lewis.
Hmm. Really? Well, parts of my proposal will have to wait until I get some money. I'll get back to you.
Sorry.
Lewis!
Buddy, just the guy I was looking for. See, I've got a problem.
Well, let me guess. You're self-centered. You're vain. You're disgustingly rich. Did you just call me Buddy?
Lewis, look, in the past, we haven't exactly seen things eye to eye.
No, we haven't. Look, I tend to see the glass as being half full. You tend to see the glass as being something to hit people with.
You're trying to be funny, right?
I know, it's wasted.
Lewis, look, how would you like a job?
Job?
I need a scientific geek type to try and help me find something.
Something? Could you be a little bit more specific?
A sea monster. Lewis, there is something out there in the ocean. And what I need is someone who knows how to use these.
Side scan, sonar, 3D radar, modeling software, thermal imaging camera. You're really serious?
Yeah. So you want the job?
When you say job, is there money involved?
Name your price.
What do you think that is?
Nothing good.
Hey, there she is. Last day as a 15-year-old. Let's celebrate. It's really
it's
not
your birthday.
Why didn't you say anything? Wilfred, wheatgrass smoothies all around, please.
Coming right up.
And you know what the best part is? I can come to your party this year.
Well, there's not going to be a...
What's been stopping you? The past few years I've had a swimming comp, but this year I'm ready to party.
Great. Can we change the subject now?
Cleo's dad throws the best parties. He goes to the works, jumping castles, clowns, ponies. Of course, we were just kids.
What a guy.
I wish my dad went all out on my birthday. Your dad's
Look, there's not going to be a party this year, so can we please just drop it?
What do you think's the matter with her?
I don't know. You mentioned her birthday party and she snaps.
Hello? Oh, hi, Mr. Satori. Yep. Cool. Okay, don't tell her. See you then. See? That explains it. That was Cleo's dad. They asked for a party for her. That must be why she's so down. She probably thinks they've forgotten.
Okay, so do we tell her?
No way.
Love, can you come here for a minute, please?
Yeah?
For the same money, we can get another balloon folder or a chihuahua dressed as a Renaissance poet who can bark the whole of I Was Made for Loving You. What do you think?
Oh, get the dog, the dog.
Don, do you think this is the best idea?
Bev, I know what Cleo wants, and she wants a humdinger of a birthday, just like last year and the year before. Don't we always have fun?
Oh, yeah, but... Yeah.
Dad's parties are the best in the world.
See? So, what do you think? Balloon folder or a chihuahua?
Man, you weren't kidding. I mean, this is expensive gear.
I told you, I don't care about money, Lewis. I'm serious. Now, do you know how to use all this stuff?
Of course. I mean, I just want to know, what's this about a sea monster?
Well, remember a couple of weeks ago when I almost drowned? I saw this.
Looks interesting.
Keep it. It's a photocopy. The original will be worth something one day.
And what is it? Is it some kind of dolphin?
No way. You're not going to find that in any book, Lewis. And whatever it is, we're going to catch it.
Hey, whoa. Stop. You know what? Actually, on second thoughts, I'm out.
What?
I'm out. Lewis. See? That's why I hang around with you guys, because all the other girls at school are like, oh no, my makeup.
Well, this is a valuable lesson. Next time Zane's drowning, don't help.
Zane's trying to track down a sea monster, and he's offered me a job helping him.
That you should take.
That's interesting logic that could work.
Hang on. Two steps back here.
Well, Zane's trying to track you down, and you know how not to find us.
Yeah, and... Lewis could steer Zane away from any no-go zones like Mako Island. This is good. Keep your friends close. Keep your enemies out in the middle of the ocean. So when's he going?
Tomorrow.
You'll miss Cleo's birthday.
Good. Cleo hates her birthday parties. She's embarrassed by them.
What? Why?
Em, how long's it been since you've been to one?
A few years ago.
Yeah, well, I've been to them all, and believe me, she has good reason. Zane, it's Lewis. We're back on. Let's go find us a sea monster.
Hello?
Happy birthday, Cleo!
Happy sweet 16th, sleepyhead.
Thanks for reminding me.
So what'd you get?
Nothing. But thanks for the thought. Now, go away, please.
Well, that went well.
Breakfast in bed for the birthday girl.
I'm asleep.
It's your favourite. Pancakes with peanut butter, banana, and honey.
Can I stay in bed?
As long as you like.
Go. Thanks, Mum.
Zane?
Glad you reconsidered.
Well, I do love a good mystery.
Did you get the $100? Right here. Is that enough? Perfect.
Stop.
Here? But this is nowhere near Mako. This is nowhere near anything.
That's the point. Solitary creature, it doesn't want to be found. I think Loch Ness Monster. This is isolated.
Right.
I'm telling you, there's monsters here.
I don't know. I was way over at Mako.
Hey, who's the geek here?
You are?
You bet I am. And when it comes to monsters, the paranormal, or anything technological, who are you going to trust? Do you want to drop the anchor?
This is just how I remember it from when we were kids. Unsettling, isn't it? I rode my first pony at Cleo's 6th birthday party. Are we sure this isn't Cleo's 6th birthday? Rikki, this is supposed to be a party. Here you go. I'm starting to see why Cleo didn't want to make such a big deal about this. Yep. The only thing missing is Cleo's dad in a cowboy suit, swooping down and slapping a party hat on her head.
Girls! Glad you could make it. Is my little gal gonna love this or what?
Are you sure that balloon animals and a pony are appropriate?
Balloon animals are ageless. She'll love it. You wait till she comes downstairs. She'll be ecstatic. Put him up, pal. Where's my horse? Sing happy birthday. She's gonna be coming down in just a minute, okay? Is everybody gets in?
About life, Lewis? Like, do you find destiny or does destiny find you? Like, things happen for a reason.
Please stop.
Something weird happened to me, and when I find out what it was, well, maybe right now. Yeah, maybe I'm on the brink of destiny. What was that? Give me a look. Give it to me.
It's just a false reading. Look, it's gone.
As if I just saw the bleep. False reading, huh? Feel that? No. That was big and strong and weird. It was headed towards Mako.
How do you know that? You don't know that.
Destiny, Lewis. This could be it. Okay, Lewis, turn the equipment on. Let's do this.
Going under then?
Not yet.
Okay, do you want me to pull up a reading?
No, I want you to do macrame. Look, I'll do
no,
it
no,
myself.
No, I've got it. Zane, I've got it. Zane, I've got it. Hey! Oh. You idiot!
What?
You! I can't believe you just did that! I thought you told me you knew how to use this thing.
I don't.
Do you have any idea how expensive it is? I'm gonna have to jump in there after it now.
Girls, more fairy bread. Bread cordial.
No, thanks.
I don't understand what's keeping Cleo at your place.
Well, you know how my mum likes to talk.
But she knows this is all here. I mean, who can resist a pony?
It can go faster! Whip it! Faster!
Can I make a small point, Mr. Satori? Cleo's kind of grown up lately. She's not the same girl as, say, Kim.
Yep, true. But all girls love ponies.
Do I look like the kind of girl that would be caught dead on a pony?
Not really.
Figure it out.
Rented, Lewis. Rented.
I'm sorry. How many times do I have to say that I am sorry?
This better be covered by insurance.
Cleo. Cleo. Ow. Cleo. Cleo.
All right. Keep your voice down.
Don't worry, the meathead's not with me.
Then why are you whispering? And what are you doing here with Zane?
It's a long story. Why aren't you at your birthday party?
Great. Did everyone know about my stupid party except me?
Don't let it get you down.
Easy for you to say. You don't have a dad who still thinks you're 6 years old.
No. Cleo, I want you to meet me at the Juice Net at 5:30,
Hey, Deaconoy! Where are you?
Cleo, at the Juice Net at 5:30.
I'm here!
What are you doing? Call of nature!
All right, well, let's get out of here before you do something even more stupid.
Oh, you are a wonderful human being, man.
Happy birthday, Cleo. Hello? Lewis? You found her. And she'll definitely be there, you're sure?
Are you ready?
For what?
Come on.
Surprise! Happy birthday, Cleo.
Happy birthday, Cleo.
You did all this.
What do you think I needed the money for?
Happy birthday, Cleo. I couldn't resist.
Thank you, Lewis. Sorry, Dad. I had to get away. You know why.
Lewis called me. How was the party?
It was really good. You didn't come.
No. You're not a little girl anymore. You're growing up, leaving me behind.
Of course I'm your girl. I always will be.
Really?
But maybe colored ball shouldn't feature so heavily in our relationship anymore. What do you say?
Deal. One last time.
Race here.